Guys, I said a dream. We didn't shoot the podcast in 7 years.
Oh, damn. I thought you were going to be a Martin Luther King right over here. I have a dream.
Brodies Lane.
No lo puedo negar. De mirar tus labios no puedo parar. Rehusando nuestro cuerpo, sudando como en el desierto. Yeah. Sabemos que la gente está de más, pero si lo pides eso puede cambiar. En solo un momento, si tú quieres puedo estar adentro. Mami, es que tú me encantas. A ti yo te rezo mi santa. Uno y habla como baila. Ninguna en la disco te alcanza. No, 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 es que tú me encantas. A ti yo te rezo mi santa. Una y habla como baila. Ninguna en la disco te alcanza.
We back, baby.
We back.
Jeez.
Season 3. Back with my brothers. I haven't seen you guys in a long time, man.
How you been, fam?
Yeah, look. Jeez. Fly. Let's see what you guys are wearing today.
You know, stand up and twirl, fam.
Oh my gosh. I thought he was going to say stand up and twerk. That would have been crazy start to the season.
Stand up and twerk. Fire. Fire if you not.
Man, guys, it's been a long time, man. Jeez. How's everybody doing? Are you all right, man?
Yeah. I'm blessed.
Welcome to the new space. We're currently in our living room now.
I love the setup.
But beyond all that, man, I missed you guys.
I know, man.
But we went from like hanging out like at least twice a week, even like with ball and stuff, to like not seeing each other at all.
Yeah.
No, but we were kind of seeing each other. We were hooping together.
Yeah.
We won a championship together.
Let's go.
Shout out Ajax.
Even though that was a
week. Shout out to my guys on Ajax.
We'll take it.
Yeah, talking about basketball, man. It felt nice to be back on the court with you guys. Felt nice to be back on the court just playing ball, man.
Yeah, you had a crazy recovery, fam.
Crazy.
Every time you jumped, we all had our breaths. Like,
remember for the first game back? I was moving, y'all were like, yo, bro, calm down. It's not that serious.
You're going hard.
I can't lie, I was shook, fam. Yeah. Remember, I was like, yo, chill.
Yeah. I mean, that was a kind of wake-up call.
Yeah.
But like, bro, it was such a good vibe to be back on the court.
It goes to show, too, like, you actually went hard with your rehab. Because the way you're moving, I was like, yo, thanks. For you to like...
Bro, went hard with the rehab, went hard with the weight loss. I mean, we've all been going at it for the weight loss.
100%. In terms
of trying to stay healthy, working out. Shout out to our guy, Mayu, for putting us on.
Shout out, Mayu.
Good time.
Here's that, man. Adapt your... update your stats.
But shout out to my guys on Ajax. We won a chip as well.
100%.
Jeez, you guys went crazy on the court.
The last game was good. Being back to our natural position.
Yeah.
It felt nice.
All the shots, you were coming off screen, layups.
I was coming off a screen, went for a layup, and I heard a man say, no!
That was deadly still.
But this is literally how we should have played for the other league. Clearly, we had things to learn.
But he was also fried injured. You could tell the difference.
Yeah. I don't know who was worse, him or Joel Embiid or Anthony Davis.
I think it's him.
Yeah, 100%. You're built like glass, man.
No. You guys know me.
But you back, though?
I played through injuries. You guys know me.
You actually did. You were putting some Himalayan salt and shit on your leg. I remember, fam. It was crazy.
He was sprinkling it while playing ball.
Pause.
Jeez.
So quickly, I know you guys are all looking fly today before we start our episode. What are you guys wearing today? Cass got a little...
None serious.
Not crazy.
A little sauce.
Lency.
Never too much sauce when we have V-Men in the cut.
What are you wearing? What tracksuit are you wearing?
It's just a regular
Adidas tracksuit. Don't say regular. Don't say regular. Don't be humble. What is that? A Celine tracksuit?
Yes, a Celine tracksuit.
Celine Dion.
Celine Dion
is goated. Guys, how's the summer been for y'all, man?
My summer's been jam-packed, man.
Yeah?
A lot of weddings. I know you guys are going to say it's not a lot when it's a couple weddings.
A couple of my close boys
got married. Shout out Saji and Nitz.
Shout out Saji and Nitz.
My boy's about to get married to Umaraj.
Shout out to my guy Uma. Yeah, that's my guy.
In August. Big wedding. A lot of good people.
So that's how your summer's been? You went to two weddings?
Three weddings. I went to Spain.
Spain was crazy.
But the funny thing.
What did you learn in Spain?
What did you learn?
Uno cerveza, por favor.
Learned that in Mexico.
But you don't even drink cerveza. It makes no sense.
Uno tequila.
But V, I don't know if you know that, but I was sending this to Cass while you were in Spain.
We had different angles.
I was getting behind the scenes of the behind the scenes.
Me?
Yeah.
Man. Wait, you were...
And I could tell you were lit.
I was lit.
I heard you were swimming, like you were the backstroke.
I was in the water.
Butterfly.
Pause. This guy said you were giving him backstrokes.
Oh, jeez. This guy said him. Oh, my God.
It was a beautiful time.
Yeah.
Good people, good vibes.
Anything you would recommend to the crowd if they were to go to Swine?
If you go to Spain, if you specifically go to Marbella, hit up a spot like now. beautiful spot to do a day party. Also, Mowgli is another beautiful spot to do a day party. And in terms of food, just go anywhere and order a paella.
Ooh, a little paella action.
Paella.
Yeah. Paella. It's the thing that comes in the bowl. It's like rice, and you can pick the ingredients you want. But the seafood paella is one of their main dishes. I mean, amazing. Could be their national dish, if I'm not wrong.
Food is amazing. People are amazing, too. But the biggest thing I would say that I took away, their lifestyle is just...
Great. A lot more relaxed.
A lot more relaxed. Not as fast-paced as Toronto or USA. Like, they're very chill. And you can see by the type of people that are there, like, their health is like their wealth. Like, I didn't see one... mildly obese person my whole time there.
So yeah.
But we don't care. You can be all shapes and sizes.
No, for sure. But I'm just saying, like, their lifestyle, like how they prioritize.
I think that's a big European thing. Yeah. Especially with that side of the world.
Yeah.
They also shut down, you know, a few countries actually shut down midday just to go home and nap and kind of relax. But did you do any shopping while you were in Spain?
No, the
reason why I'm asking you guys, Spain, if you want to shop for clothes or whatever the case may be, the cheapest place to shop in while you're in Europe.
No, mostly a lot of like souvenirs, but I know you told me to check out the Zara.
The Zara there is nuts. And the selection there is like all summer selection. Yeah. Like, so they get stuff like we'll never see here.
Yeah.
And Zara is from Spain, so they get
Zara's
preference.
Zara's from Spain?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that.
You didn't meet Zara over there?
He's back with season 3, back with Casper's shit jokes.
Yeah, volume shooting. But yo, Casper, how's your summer been, man?
Yo, it feels like summer just started and it's just been raining like crazy.
Dude, the rain has been insane.
That flood, though?
Ooh.
You got stuck?
I heard you were stuck on the DVP, left your car, and then walked
off. I swam here.
I heard you were swimming like you were swimming in Marbella.
To be honest, my summer has been okay.
Yeah.
Just been doing the whips.
Yeah.
Past classics.
He's been doing the whips, and he's been getting whipped.
Pause. No, but nothing crazy, fam. Honestly, I'm going to Tulum next week.
Ooh.
That should be fun.
Tulum.
Ruben was saying it was crazy expensive.
Yeah, Tulum is crazy expensive, but you're going with a good crew, so I know you're going to have a good time.
Yep.
Don't do anything crazy. Don't make decisions when you're drunk, because that's when you end up spending even more money.
Yeah, man.
Don't just walk into the club and say you want five bottles of tequila. No point.
No clubbing in Tulum.
But that's the thing. That's not really clubbing there. It's more like restaurants that turn into like, you know. Yeah. It's a good vibe, though. I think you'll enjoy it.
I think I like it.
It's very Casper-like.
It'll be a good reset for you, too, you know?
Yeah.
This guy keeps telling me every trip I go on is a reset.
You need a reset, though.
Yeah. The band doesn't need a reset every 2 months,
I'm like, yo, V, I'm going on a trip. Yeah, that's a good reset.
Yeah.
Yo, V, I'm going to Niagara Falls. Yeah, that's a great reset.
V-Man, I'm going to Scarborough, bro. That's a reset you really need.
Yeah, I'm going to the Washington. That's a definite reset.
Yo, they need you back to Scarborough still.
Yeah, bro, I miss Scarborough, man. Scarborough is
really good. This guy said I miss Scarborough. It's been like 30 years since you lived there.
No, you're asking us about our summer. That was your summer.
Man, bro, I don't know if you guys know, but I've been hustling this summer. I've been working.
Your schedule is fried.
Every time you guys call me, I was working. But shout out to my guys, Cass and V, man. Y'all showed up and helped me out when I needed some help for some of the wedding shoots.
Some more shit for you.
The love you guys been getting while people spotted you guys at the wedding is kind of crazy. Why don't you guys share some of the stories?
Some guy leaked him like, yo, you work for Dream Factory? That's crazy.
That's a complete lie. But yeah, no, I was shooting at the wedding. I was obviously helping you out. Like,
yeah.
Just to see how much work that goes into, like, what you do.
It's crazy.
Like, your craft.
Stop, like, I can't lie,
how actually. You make it such an enjoyable experience for the couple. Like,
yeah.
It goes above and beyond. Like, I've worked with other videographers and, like, the attention to detail and how nice you are with your
couple. Yeah. Yeah, good times.
I'm gonna holler at you for my weddings.
100%. Holler at me for your weddings. But yeah, I shot, like, at one point, I think I shot 9 out of 10 days.
Yeah.
And I think I went days with like 45 minutes sleep, 30 minutes sleep. Also went to Europe for an e-shoot over there.
Oh, that
video was
crazy. Yeah, I was what? Yeah,
also, all your videos have been going crazy.
Been going crazy. The views have been racking up. So I did a few shoots in Lake Como and in Switzerland. Drop a few teasers right here. No. I've been crazy with that wedding. So right now, since we're back in the studio, it's also Adi Masam for the wedding season. So it's going to be a little break. So it's going to give us some time to...
Would you ever shoot like other couples that are not Tamil?
100%. I mean, like the last wedding we shot, it was a church wedding / Hindu ceremony. Typically during this time, you'll get a lot more like Catholic Christian weddings.
Yeah.
But when it comes to the Hindu side of things, it's going to be a complete stop for a month.
Yeah. Why did they do that?
It's just, I believe it's bad luck or something in the time. This one month.
Like, what's the number? Like, what date?
I think it's like July 15th to August 15th. It kind of varies, but it's around that same time frame. So it's going to give us some time to get a few pods going, trying to release some as soon as possible. I know you guys have been asking. And shout out to all the people that's been coming up to us everywhere we're going, showing us so much love.
Yeah. Honestly, fam, it's like a good feeling to have. Because I don't think people watch us.
Yeah.
It's how I feel, you know? But when people come up to you and they're like, yo, you guys are sick, I'm like, oh, shit.
No, that's crazy because a lot of people say, guys, you're always downplaying yourself. Yeah. Like, people are not watching, but you'd be surprised with the amount of people watching. And the amount of love I've been getting, like, I went to a bride's house and she's like, oh, my gosh, podcast came strong. And I was like, what?
Oh,
it was kind of crazy. And it was the bride. But even when you guys showed up, they're like, oh, my gosh, the podcast guys are here. It was kind of crazy. I mean, that was the only time we had to kind of connect this summer.
Yeah.
But yeah, it feels back to be home, to be honest. We haven't shot here in a while.
Feels good, man.
Honestly, it feels good because it's like, yo, all your videos, you have like crazy songs.
Yeah.
MJ Melodies.
MJ Melodies been spitting some crazy fire.
So like, what's your summer song?
Ooh, summer song. I know Casper's probably going to hate on this, but it's the Drake track with Camila. What's it called again? Uptown?
Yeah, see, what's it called again?
Yeah. Uptown.
That can't be the summer track. If you say, what's it called again? It's not... No.
It's a vibe.
It's not that it's ass. It's just... Yeah. Yo, it's not a vibe like that, man. You guys are overplaying it. Okay, fine.
But the other song that's been on repeat, and I shouldn't be supporting the song, but Not Like Us, been hitting different.
They're not like us.
Jeez, but yo, Damar, you canceled.
Damar's banned from the city.
Yeah. They're bumping that song everywhere.
Oh, I thought you were doing ad-lib, sorry. Is the bar cancelled?
I don't think so.
No?
Like, I feel like we don't care. We can't give him that much credit. He's not that sick to be cancelled.
Wow.
No,
DeMar is a Toronto legend. But showing up to music shoots and concerts and being on stage when there's a Drake diss track, I feel a certain way about that.
Yeah. It's also like, you seen the interview, you said like, yo, like Kendrick's like family, like he grew up in Compton, like he was around.
No, but that's playing middleman though.
Yo, those are the worst type of men.
Yeah. Like, yeah, diss me and then say, yo, that's my family, I'm sorry.
It's like Casper dissing you on a song.
Yeah.
And I'm with you being like, yeah. Yeah.
Yo, me, man, you're sick.
Yeah, you're a sick man. Yeah, yeah.
That's super dust.
That's super wild.
Yeah, you can't be doing that. I don't think he's cancelled enough to be, I don't think he's big enough to be cancelled. That's why we kicked him out of Toronto anyways.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sent him packing. So I think he's kind of cheesed about that.
Okay, but...
summer song for you, Cass.
What's your summer song right now?
Any
summer songs?
Gata only was...
Any cringe. Summer songs you're working on, or...
No.
Are you cooking in the lab?
You know, the only thing I'm cooking in is some mutton curry.
Jeez. Never had it yet. Pause. So, sorry, what was that song? I cut you off, my bad.
It was called Gata Only.
You've never heard Gata Only? Did you send it to us?
Yeah.
Fire track.
We literally used the track.
That was Santa.
Santa Only?
Yeah. Nah, Santa Fe.
Yeah, Santa Fe.
That's my crazy summer check. That's my summer check. And also Tori's Girls Around the World.
I still haven't heard it.
It's dope.
Yeah.
It's not one of his best work, but it's good.
Is it one of his like older tracks?
It's one of his old tracks they released it, but it's just nice hearing Tori after not hearing for so long, you know? And also shout out to boy Sam, Leticia.
Oh yeah, Sam's been going crazy.
Sam got a follow by Drake?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Crazy. That's a big follow.
That's big.
Now,
Sam, put us on that Drake mansion. Yeah. Drake mansion flooded, though.
Yeah,
if Drake's house could flood, Toronto could flood.
I heard you're at the gates with the mop. You're like, Drake, let me come out.
Heard you were drinking the water.
He's like,
that's super wild.
Whoa.
Y'all ran along with this one. No. But yo, the water was so brown, Drake was like, yo, I hope this is espresso martinis.
No, but you know what's fried? That's how you know whoever built that shit built it poorly, fam. To leak that bad?
Yeah, that was a bad leak. Fam.
But also, yo, the rain was...
No, but like, fam.
No, but...
Worse. That's a bad leak.
No, it wasn't how the house is built. It also has an indoor pool.
Oh.
That's where the leak came from.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, so...
How do you know all this inside information?
Come on, man.
How do you know he has an inside pool?
Facts by Ben.
He's got to swim through the fucking pipes.
Wow.
I heard you came out of the leak, fam. That's crazy, dog.
Came out of what league?
Oh my God.
The man said they not like us.
This is why we took a few months break, guys. Yeah, we had to take a break from this garbage ass joke.
So Drake's been trending.
Garbage ass jokes. Yo, we're sorry.
Drake's been trending.
Kendrick's been trending. But you know who else has been trending?
Ruben.
Hawk Tuah. Jeez. No, it's funny because every interview is about that now.
Tamils actually invented it first. Tuah. Imagine all the Tamil aunties back then. Like Hawk Tuah.
Yeah, honestly, like even when they're like trying to get like the evil eye away from me, they're like, "Oh, yeah. Can you do on this?"
That's why I saw the Tamil uncle go like this when she did. That's crazy. That's crazy.
You know what they're just missing? They're
like, that's actually
she don't hawk to her. I don't want to talk to her.
I think that went right over your head, fam. Yeah.
You don't even take it. He doesn't
what,
take
the,
it.
What the Tamil man went like this?
Fam, the Tamil
when they go for an evil eye.
What?
Super wild! I didn't think of that, bro. That's insane.
That's crazy.
But yo, she's been trending, bro, yeah, to a point where everyone's asking every girl about that.
Yeah.
For
the people that don't know, can you kind of explain what the whole thing is?
So, like, explain it. Why are you putting this on us?
I'll explain it.
Go for it.
So basically means.
So you know we're very.
No, you said let him explain it. So why are you jumping in?
Okay, yeah, okay. This guy's like, no, you explain it. And it starts talking. No, go.
Go ahead.
Take it.
No, explain it.
Just explain it.
You're doing such a good job.
Okay, we're not spending the next 10 minutes trying to explain it.
Based pretty much on hawk to a.
Yo, why you don't have to do it? That's dirty, fam.
Yeah.
Nah, fam. What do you mean?
The way you did it right into the mic. Fire. We gotta use these mics at a different part, bro.
So listen. So we live in a day and age where you know men like pleasure, women like pleasure. And
pleasure.
The act of the hawk tuah is pretty much a woman giving a pleasurable favor to a man.
Yeah.
In a very satisfying manner.
But do you guys why'd you dap me while licking your lips? That was so sketch.
Yeah, so but do you guys think that's satisfying?
Why are you asking? I was like, well, obviously.
So you like the hawk tuah?
100%. We gotta take this invite away from the Diddy party right now.
Pause.
Oh. Yo, we haven't heard from Diddy since, eh? Crazy. Yeah, screw that guy.
No, but where are you from?
But question.
Okay.
Do men prefer pretty girls or funny girls?
So funny girls like the hawk tuah girl.
I like pretty funny girls.
You can't get.
Nah, no, I'm kidding.
This guy just mixed both.
Yeah.
What's hybrid?
Why should I go buy a Tesla?
This kind of goes back to our conversation where
you just like to hop to on everything.
Jesus Christ. Honestly, I think a funny girl would be dope.
Okay, but that's not the question.
The hawk tuah girl, she's funny.
Yeah.
She wasn't super bad.
Yeah.
But you would want to be around those vibes. You know?
I feel like funny supersedes, like, obviously, you don't want someone that's, like, super burst, but like, I'm saying, like, funny supersedes that because, yo, the personality is going to go along.
Personality goes crazy.
Exactly why I said this goes back to that previous conversation we had in terms of personality or looks.
Yeah, because for me, it's like, when we were younger, we would possibly go for the pretty girl, right?
Yeah.
But now that we're older, we'd be like, yo, funny girl's more because... It's just the convenience of being around someone that jokes, you can vibe. Yeah,
you can tell with the interaction right off the bat if you know which way this is going to go.
But let me ask you this. Do you wife the funny girls or do you friend up the funny girls? V-Man could answer this question.
V-Man, answer. Do you wife up the funny girls or do you friend zone that?
Wife up the funny girl, for sure.
Yeah.
So why haven't you?
You're a pretty funny guy, funny girl. Bro, it's going
to
be a...
It makes it good because you want that friendly banter, you know? I feel like that keeps the... relationship interesting, plus also like when you come back from work, whether it's a tough, like a rough day, like,
yeah,
you know, if she's making you laugh, you're like, okay, like that's an ease of mind, you know?
That's it.
I like that.
Shout out to the goofballs. Even if you're not as pretty, y'all are beautiful.
Jeez. Man, that was a backhanded compliment.
No, no.
Just super wild.
That was super wild.
Also, beauty is in the eye of the beholder, so like, you know?
But have you guys done any clubbing this summer?
No.
I know you've been to like 17 Soccer Die events. How are those?
Honestly, let me ask you this. Do you pre-buy them like year, but like 5 years at a time?
I bought like a decade pass.
Really?
I bought one like 10 years ago.
So like do you danced with one of the moms in 2020?
And then you met the daughters a decade later?
That's crazy.
You guys are chopped.
What would you do if that actually happened though?
What?
Like you imagine you danced with a girl in 2014.
Okay.
Then right now, like 2024.
The girl comes up to me like, I'm your daughter.
No, so this actually, a similar situation happened where the mom and the daughter went out together.
To soak or die?
To soak or die.
And you've dealt with both of them?
I heard about it. So mom and daughter went out to soak or die. And then two of my boys were dancing with both of them. They didn't realize who they were. And then the mom pulled the daughter away. He's like, hey, we got to go home. And the both of them looked at each other like, what's going on here? And then the mom said, yeah, this is my daughter.
Yeah.
So
then I was like, where's your father?
Clearly not in the picture.
He needs the father there.
No, but seriously, bro, if you even if you bought these tickets and resold it, like, it'd be crazy, right? Yeah, like, people are willing to pay a hefty amount for these tickets.
If you buy it in bulk, because I know some people that are reselling it, they bought it for, like, $60. Some of them are flipping it for, like, $120, bro.
How much do you pay for your ticket by the time you get your hands on it?
No. I usually try to buy it on, like...
Oh, so you get it on time?
When I get it
on time. Like, do you wait in, like, the online to wait to click?
Yeah.
Do you run into like a lot of familiar faces at these events?
Yeah. I usually go with the same crowd. D-Patch, Rich.
Why do you never ask us?
Huh? I asked you guys. You guys said you're too cool.
Wow. Yeah, but let me ask you this.
I was trying to celebrate the Asia Championship there.
Do you get bored of going to the same party every year?
It's not necessarily the same party. And I don't really get bored because I'm going with my people. And like, we vibe wherever we go.
Perfect segue into going with your people. Yeah. Would you rather go to the club with or without your girl?
I feel like there's pros and cons to both.
But the question is one
that's
or the other.
Good question. That's a good question. Think we can answer, please?
No. Why am I answering all these questions? How come you guys can't?
That's true. That's very true. What about you?
I want to answer that.
You guys are dodging all the...
This guy said that's... Yo,
also, I wasn't just at Soccer Day. I was at DJ Cal events. They're amazing. They're lit.
Yo.
Shout out DJ Cal.
Yeah. Yo, shout out... Yo, this guy's like... This guy's like, yeah, that's true. Cass, what's your answer? No, you answer. Would you rather go clubbing with your wifey? Or leave her at home.
Honestly, it totally depends. Like, it's if the wife is into the clubbing thing, like, obviously, I'd like to take her.
I think to go with your partner clubbing is dope.
Yeah.
Just get dumb smashed. You just vibe.
But then I think about it. I'm like, yo, do we still have clubs in Toronto? Is that even a thing these days? No, right?
Yeah. I feel like for our age group now, like, we're kind of like segueing out of it.
Exactly. Yeah. I mean, I've been out of
it. More like day parties.
Or like, I feel like clubbing, like, when you're in a different country, it's a whole different experience. Yeah. I think I enjoy
it. But also, more. Like, when you were younger... Every weekend was supposed to be clubbing. Like, yo, what are you saying this weekend?
Bro, so for me, every weekend it was like, every weekend, literally.
Like, you're basically a promoter.
Yeah, at that point, yeah, might as well. Like, this guy promotes Soak or Die. Yeah.
Soak or Die.
What about you, man? With or without your girl?
I think with would be more fun.
Yeah.
To be honest, it's like, if you're single, go clubbing. But if you have a girl, I think going with your girl is more fun.
Yeah.
Because if you go without your girl, what the fuck are you going to do at the club?
Yeah.
You're going to stand there?
I mean, some guys go to the clubs with their girl, and then the girl will get hit on, and then it turns into an absolute nightmare.
Also, you can't go to clubs being insecure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that's one of the major things.
And like, there's been a lot of cases I've seen where men, especially brown men, are very insecure.
Yeah, very insecure.
Does that still happen, though? Have you seen it in recent times?
I've seen it such a long time because I go to DJ Cal events where no fights happen. A lot of
promo.
The plug is wild. I like it.
I feel like it does still happen. Especially with the younger crowd.
Yeah.
Yeah, because you know man's egos come into play. Like
egos.
Insecurities. I also feel like with the younger crowd, especially in like the brown community, these guys don't go to clubs for girls, fam. They go to clubs to fight.
Yeah.
The guy's waiting. He's like, I'm on. Screamed at me. I'm 10 shots deep. Next guy that I'm going to slap him.
Yeah.
No, the pre-juice really gets to the man early.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Some of these brown guys, fam, like, they're very, like you said, they're very insecure. So once the alcohol hits, that's when, like, they're a little...
Yeah.
But shout out to the guys that actually go there for a good time.
Yeah,
you can see them just pop the bottles, do their own thing, you know?
Good time, you're with your circle, like, they're not in it for the drama.
Yo, at what age did you guys actually start popping bottles? That's a good question.
21.
Damn, that's fucking early.
I mean, I think my first drink was when I was 21.
Yeah, or your drink, but not, like...
But my first drink is when I bought the bottle on my birthday.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You only drank at 21?
Yeah.
In high school, you never drank?
No.
Damn.
Yeah, started a little late. I mean, I think I made up for it by now.
I feel like for me...
LCBO went on strike after you started drinking.
Yeah, LCBO strike's been reckless. Are they still on strike? They are, right?
No, I heard they were making some crazy money, fam.
Yeah, so the bars are making extra money right now because they mans can't get drinks.
Yeah.
So the bars are like doubling on their liquor right now.
All the dollar bottle guys are charging crazy prices right now.
There was a guy
I asked, one guy wanted two bills.
Yeah.
For what?
For a Casamigos.
Crazy.
No way.
Yeah, I was like,
that's probably on the lower end now.
Yeah, that's the lower end. Yeah, it's crazy.
It's crazy.
Wait, so there's no LCBO right now?
No.
I don't drink, so I don't really take it. Wait, so my question is, when I saw.
But when will the cap stop?
I don't drink like that. Let me ask you this. Do I drink like that?
Yeah, you do. Like when you're on vacation, you take the bottle to the washroom. Yeah,
vacation is different. That's true. I'm not sitting here.
Vacay Casa is a whole different beast.
Vacay Casa, I like that. Bottle into the washroom, come out, it's half empty.
Yeah, but doing bottle service with gas is the worst.
I see half the bottle. Why is it yellow?
Yo, I went in with Casamigos. Fam, I went in with Casamigos, came out with whiskey.
You went in with the silver, came back with gold. Yeah, that's wild.
No, like, when I say... Wait, so I'm confused. Did I not see an article where, like, it said, like, you can buy LCBO bottles or, like, alcohol bottles at a convenience store starting, like, Thursday or something?
Yeah, but I think there's a full stop to that right now.
That's
what he wants. He wants to turn it into, like, you know, the Montreal atmosphere where you could get liquor anytime, anywhere.
There's some stores in Ontario that are like that. They're like gas station stores, liquor
stores. Yeah, but those gas stations are combined with LCBO.
LCBO.
So it's not an actual thing store, but the goal is to find a way to...
LCBO basically goes out of business, right? Eventually, they'll close down LCBOs?
But I don't know.
So now it's like a government run. They're trying to obviously make it private.
Yeah.
To, like, capitalize on that, but...
I'm sure they still end up buying it from them. Yeah. I don't know, like, will they get a special... Where do you get liquor from? Exactly. Yeah, I don't know.
Premise behind it, but imagine, like, how the city's going to be. Like,
yeah.
People are just going to walk in to convenience stores where there's going to be people working, like, elderly people, and they're just going to walk out.
Yeah.
And then steal the bottles. Like, that's going
to
be...
The bottle stealing, bro? Come on, man.
Honestly,
I know everyone's making Indian jokes. Yeah, and, like,
it's actually bad, man.
But I think they're doing that to survive. I'm not supporting it by anything, but, like, it sucks because... Man, like, you got women doing it with the guys.
Yeah.
And they seem like they don't know what they're doing. And they're like, yeah, I'll show my face, whatever. Take this and then trying to find a way to live.
Yeah.
No, but you, honestly, it's actually such a horrible thing that, like, Canada has become, like, this immigrant-run country. Like, we were just trying to plan to go to Niagara Falls. And we literally, you just said, like, yo, it's overrun by Indians.
Yeah.
And it's not even being racist, fam. It's just like... Like, when did we allow this much people to come in?
Yeah, it's crazy.
I swear, at one point, getting into Canada was hard when we were coming back from back home. Like, you snuck in through Switzerland.
Yeah.
Where'd you sneak in from?
We all snuck in.
You came from Montreal.
Yeah, this guy claimed that he was Singalese.
And I got on it.
But yeah, no, I think the streets of Toronto are kind of crazy right now.
Yeah.
Saw another article where...
Those crazy Indian fights?
The crazy Indian fights in plazas? What is that about, man?
Yeah.
They're like beating each other up at every Indian plaza in Brampton.
Yeah, it's actually fried still.
The other one I saw today...
Crazy racist joke.
I'm not a racist, guys, but I was going to make a racist joke.
I was like, yo...
The other one I saw today, bro, is like... They're saying men are taking shits on by the beaches.
Yeah, I heard about that. And then you sent us a link where they're sleeping out in tents.
Bro, next that's to crazy. Yeah.
I saw that one.
Did I send the link?
Yo, but no.
He did.
Yo, but you know what's weird? Yeah. I don't see any of this where I live.
Yeah.
I don't see the Markham.
Yeah, because you live with all the Asians. Yeah.
Yeah, I actually don't see the Markham. Yeah. You know?
Have you seen it
in Milton? No, you haven't.
No.
Milton does have.
How about downtown? Areas. Downtown
no,
doesn't have.
More, there's more. You know what actually? There's more Pakis
in
Milton.
It's actually Brampton.
Bramladesh.
No, but for real though, I feel like it's in Brampton, right? Like, that's where everything is happening.
I mean,
Scarborough too.
That's where they're all going because that's where most of their families are. They kind of relate to other people in the city.
It's just crazy how you can come from a country like India,
yeah,
and then start doing the wild shit you'll do in India, like people crossing streets like it's India, driving through lights.
And I think that's the only annoying part is when they move or anyone, not just Indian, but they keep the same habits.
Canadian ones,
exactly,
because that's what makes Canada better. But they make it worse by doing a... Fam, a guy said he went to a show. I saw it on TikTok. He said a client wanted to list his house. He went there and found out 19 students live in a three-bedroom house.
Yeah, I saw that.
He's like, I'm not listing this. Yeah. He's like, imagine I list it, I sell it, then it happens that the 19 people don't want to move out.
We're also not knocking on our Indian brothers and sisters. We're not any better because we do the same thing. So we picked up all the people from Jaffna, we put them in Europe, and they haven't changed their habits. So if you...
Really? Europe's like that?
100%. Like, Switzerland, Paris, Germany. They literally still move like
We're not living in tents, taking shits in public parks.
Yeah.
But that's
because of the population, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. And people not willing to rent out their properties to these guys.
It's also not fair, like, because we don't know every situation.
Yeah, we don't know the situation.
We're judging it based off of, like, what we're seeing.
But it's also these schools that are promising a better future, letting them come here and realizing...
It's not schools, bro. It's the agencies.
Schools.
It's the agencies.
The private lying. Schools that are saying, like, yo, our courses are going to give you, like, the equal amount of power as, like, a George Brown or like universities, then they come out to find out that degree doesn't means nothing.
No, that school doesn't even exist.
It exists, yeah.
So a lot of people come in and they have all these falsified documents.
They stopped that, you know?
Yeah, but it's hard to catch up on that. Mm-hmm.
All right, so we were just talking about Indians. You know how they go on vacation to Niagara Falls. So, where's a vacation spot or a destination where you wouldn't allow your partner to go to?
Ibiza.
Why Ibiza?
Yeah.
Why Ibiza?
Huh? Party Central? Drug Central?
Yeah.
Crazy.
Really?
Yeah. Wouldn't want my girl to go there.
I think I would say Miami.
Oh, no way. Bro, every girl goes to Miami. You've been to Miami.
What do you mean every...
I think Miami is like a hot spot for girls, no?
I think Miami... I think what's that weekend in Miami?
Oh, no, no. He's talking about summer, spring break.
Spring break Miami.
Yeah, that's not
Miami any time else.
Don't go to spring break. If you go to
spring break Miami, you're getting your sprung broke.
You're
getting your sprung. Shari's getting sprung.
Yeah. Going back to T-Pain, unsprung.
How about you, V?
I probably agree with both of you guys.
No. Yeah, you need your own spot. I don't know.
I was thinking like. You guys said both of them.
Yeah.
No, you weren't thinking both of them.
Will you allow them to go to Marbello?
Huh? Of course.
Yeah.
Because they got...
V-Man's going to say, I don't... She could go anywhere she wants.
100%.
Yeah.
V-Man's
wow!
Like,
100%.
No, honestly, realistically speaking...
Realistically, it's about reciprocation. If I don't allow her to go anywhere...
Bro, it's season 3, bro. The brownie points thing...
I don't care about brownie
points. Cut it out, man.
No. I think V's actually like that.
What?
He's like, if you clap, I clap. Like,
no, if you're
if real, I clap, everyone can clap.
If you're real, if you keep it real with your partner, like, go anywhere.
Yeah, but we understand that. But the question is,
where's one spot?
We can say that too, you know. We can say that.
Right?
Yeah.
There's one spot, though, you were such a dog in that if a girl went there, it's fried.
Yeah.
What do you mean?
This guy's like, one of us go in, everyone could go through it.
The question was vacation spot you wouldn't allow your partner to go to.
Yeah.
I would allow my partner to go to any vacation.
Oh my God.
So you're okay with her going to
a resort? So what's the point of us taking the time to write these questions down, to ask you these questions, if you're going to give us the politically correct
opinion? So you're okay with your girl going to like a Mexican resort?
Yeah.
And her phone died for 7 days straight.
Okay, that's
but then you're adding the sauce.
Okay, how about this?
Yeah.
Let me ask you this. Is this a good one?
No, but can we get an answer out of it?
No, that's what's actually.
That's your actual answer.
Like, your girl can go anywhere.
Yeah.
Yo, whoever date ends up with V, just know you can do anything you want.
Yeah.
As long as he can do it too.
Reciprocation. You just don't do shit.
So, like, you're into like open relationships and shit.
No, it's not open relationships. You guys are trying to misconstrue the question.
No. Jeez, I like that word. Say it again.
No.
Miss what?
That's how I feel.
Miss construction? Okay, so let me ask you this.
When will you change, bro?
Let me ask you this.
This is also the guy that said I'll be friends with my ex.
Are you the type of guy to allow your girl to go anywhere,
huh?
But the moment she fucks up, you'll like set boundaries after that or no?
100%.
So are you the type of guy that's going to be okay if she fucks up?
Huh?
Yeah. No. So let's say she goes.
No, how about this?
Phone died for 7 days. She comes back. Are you okay with that?
Like, if I'm with a girl, like, we would establish that before any trips are...
So, like, before every trip, like, don't worry about the phones.
The phone has to be charged. Like, you go to Apple, get a diagnostic report.
Pretty much, the answer is, don't do anything you wouldn't want me doing. Done.
So, would you want her to soak or die?
With me? Yeah, hell yeah.
No, okay, so what if she wanted to soak or die
without you?
Without you.
Like, one year, like, you chose that your pass expired and, like, she kind of renewed
it. No. She tells you, I'm going to soak or die, you stay home this time.
No, I'm going. I'm coming with it.
Oh. Yo, honestly, this is an annoying subject. Let me bring something. You know what I hate the most? The couples that go clubbing and then go their separate ways inside the clubs.
Yeah.
I've seen too many of those.
Oh,
the girls will go with the girl.
Actually?
The mandem is just... So, like, let's say, like, we all go together, right? And you're, like, not you. But, like, you're not you either. Like, one of our boys' girls come to the club.
Yeah.
Then she's like, babes, I'll be back. And she disappears with her girls inside the club.
That's a no-no.
That's a no-no.
Yeah.
I mean, if they planned it that way, it's different. But like, if you go together and then all of a sudden you guys both go your separate ways, what's the point of that?
Is
like, I remember there was a
story. That relationship is called an open relationship.
Yeah. I remember I saw this funny story. There was a guy. He was like, "Yo, I couldn't afford the bottles, so when my girl went to like other booths, I didn't really do anything."
You're making the shit up on the spot.
I swear to God, if I'm lying, I'm dying. A man actually, word for word, had told this to somebody I know, and it's factual information.
Say that again.
A man I knew
Yeah.
told no A guy I know was told from another guy this exact story.
Okay.
That he allowed
look his at the girls, camera there and tell
he him. Allowed his girls to go. He allowed his girl to go to the club and bottle hop because he couldn't afford to do it.
If that's happening, guys, right now, I'm flabbergasted. Yes.
But what if, like, you go to the club one day, you forgot your credit card.
Yeah.
She's like, babe, that guy's pouring shots. I'm going to go. I'll be back.
Yeah.
What would you do?
If she goes...
I'll be like this.
Yeah, that's
an X. That's a cut.
I'll be like this.
V-Man's going to be like, yo, bring me one too?
Nah.
V-Man's like...
Come on.
V-Man's like...
There's like...
Yo, yo, V-Man's like this. If you do it, I'll do it too. Hey, pour me a shot.
Like, hey, baby, you gotta give me... No. Like, let's say you go to a club. Yeah. You're with your girl.
Oh, and man,
then,
me.
And then she's walking, and then a guy pulls her into the booth, and then she starts taking shots in the booth. And then...
kind of shots? Like behind shots?
No, like Casamigos or whatever. Or Hennessy.
Yeah.
And then you try to walk into the booth, the guy's like, nah, you gotta stay out there. And meanwhile, she sees that you're not allowed in, and she keeps taking shots.
Yo, bro, pause.
Bro, that's wild.
One, if my girl got pulled in and she stayed, I'm walking the next way. I'm not trying to get into the booth. Yeah. Hey, sorry.
No, that's my girl.
pour it a little lower. Just too much.
No, that's actually wild. If that.
I've seen some wild stuff.
Yeah.
The girl will be dancing the next man. The guy will be standing there holding his hand.
Yeah.
Well, I've seen that too. That I've seen.
Or like if they like what you said, like the group split apart, and then the girl's like having too much fun. The guy will go grab her and be like, "Oh, let's go."
Okay, enough.
What if like you're just daggering a girl, then a man comes and pulls her away. But she's like, no. Would you be like, yo, chill, let her dance?
Wow. No. What do you mean? That's not even a conversation to have.
What if she's like...
If that's happening right now, I don't even know what to tell you.
You think that... Fam, I've heard some wilder shit like...
There's some crazy shit that we can't talk about on God, but like, it's just...
There's like some fried shit.
Jeez.
Just message V on the side.
Some relationships are questionable still. Like, if you don't feel comfortable with your partner, don't go.
I mean, the relationship is only questionable if it's not an open relationship. If it's an open relationship, there's nothing to question about that.
But real question, what's your thoughts on open relationships?
That's not for me. Super dirty. It's actually weird.
Open relationship.
It's weird in so many ways.
Like, I don't know. Like, I feel like it's only like white people that do that.
Dude, you'll be surprised. I think the brown community is very open to open relationships these days. Yeah.
I feel like brown girls,
they're
like a bunch of wastemans and they'll be like, yo, baby, stay home. I'll go.
Yeah.
So I know a person that like,
That's an open relationship?
No, that's an open relationship. He's a white guy.
Bro?
He's a white guy. He's like, he was just talking to me. Basic conversation. He's just like, my wife just came home from a date. And I'm like, what?
Like,
I'm like, what? I was like, explain further. He's like, we're in an open relationship. Like, she goes on dates. I go on dates. Like,
But hold on. Are they, like, married? They're married?
They're married. And
so they're swingers.
They're open relationships.
Swing is a whole different ballgame. That's a whole different ballgame. You purposely go to a spot to do that.
So
together. That's swinging.
So she's like, she went on a date with like a good looking Asian guy apparently. Yeah, like she had a great time. Like I think she spent the night or something.
Honestly,
like,
the
premise of that, like,
is fucked.
Like, it's
fucked.
I'd love to meet that friend of yours. Yeah.
Why?
Just so I can laugh.
I think he'll be a great guest.
Yeah.
He'd be like, yesterday she came home from a date and like she couldn't walk.
Yeah.
I had to help her.
He also told me that like, there was a time
after I gave her my crutches.
There's also a time where she's like, she went away for a week with her sugar daddy. Like, she paid.
Okay, what the fuck?
You have to reevaluate some of your friendships, man.
No, it's not. It's not like a friend like that.
Like he's a guy you met on Facebook.
Acquaintance.
Like acquaintance, like a work. Like a
so let me ask you this.
Like a worker.
Yeah, like, he's a worker. His wife is a worker, I'm here. but
there are instances like that it's normal.
I agree.
Relationships are like normal.
Yeah, it's actually the norm in 2024.
I think open relationships are super dirty.
No, for us, it's not normal, but it's a normal thing in today's day and age.
To touch on the topic, like further down the road, I had the same conversation with him, and he's like, I'm like, yo, how's everything going with your family? He's like, I was starting to get jealous, like, and like all these things were happening.
Duh!
Exactly. See, like, you regret that later.
Because he tried to clap, and she's like, it's not the same. That's crazy.
I can walk after you.
Oh my god. She's like, babe, oh my god, I'm so happy I can walk.
No crutches.
He's like, babe, let me go get the crutches. No, not for you, babe.
Post-nut clarity. He's like,
post-nut clarity is a thing.
Is it really?
It's actually,
Tell me more.
Tell us more, Casper.
No, tell us about the oxygen.
Honestly, the oxygen into 3, 4, 5, 6.
We mean oxygen, guys, but
Casper. That's because like the other day we were all talking and I kind of blabbered. I was like, "Yo, what do you mean oxygen?"
We're talking about like my job, and then they're like, "Oh, like do you give oxygen?" They're obviously making dirty jokes about oxygen and stuff. And then Casper's like,
"So, oh, do you give oxygen?" I have a good question for you.
But remember when she sprained her ankle and you said, "I have to give you CPR." What?
No. This guy's like 21, 21. She's not breathing. She's like, "What do you mean? I'm fine." No, no, no. I gotta grab her mouth right now.
You guys are fried.
Facing south.
Oh, crazy. She's like, "Yeah, I think I have a migraine." Yeah, get in the back of the truck.
Yo, let me ask you this. You know, you guys saw that OnlyFans video where like the girl.
No, we didn't see any OnlyFans videos, man. This guy makes it seem like we're sitting on OnlyFans.
No, not sitting on OnlyFans. It was an OnlyFans video that got leaked.
To her account?
I don't have OnlyFans.
So how do you watch the video?
Yeah. Because it got. Let me finish the conversation.
Come on, man.
Look, let me
capping.
Let me
finish. Capping.
You didn't let me finish the conversation. I said the OnlyFans video that got leaked on Twitter. That was a girl getting, like, an officer getting clapped by, like, one of the inmates.
So you saw it?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that's... Never heard of that. No, one.
Yeah.
I didn't see the video, but I heard about it.
The lies, yo, fam.
No, the video...
That's so normal, though. You hear about that all the time.
Yeah, that's actually a normal thing.
Yo, so let me ask you this. Yeah. So if a patient paid you to clap her in back of the ambulance, would you do it?
No.
No, like, if you got paid a million?
No.
A million?
No. You would say no to a million?
A million, a crib, and a whip. And residual income, so you'll start getting 10k a month.
And a after Hawk Tuah.
Yeah, in that video, she'll Hawk Tuah you.
Oh my gosh. Okay. Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
How about you, Ruben? I'm joking.
About to cancel the spot.
Yeah. To be honest, if someone paid me a mil, we got to be honest here.
Yeah. What circumstances do you do the CPR?
What?
Yeah.
Yo, they're thank dead. You. Yo, hold on.
That's
pause.
The only reason we do CPR if they're dead.
So why'd you do it? I saw her die.
Yo, fam, you know when Katie was like doing the shooting forms in the club?
Yeah.
He was practicing CPR in the club.
Jeez.
No, but for me, if somebody paid me a mil.
Yeah.
To make a video at my work environment.
Yeah.
If I'm single. And you said a mil? Yeah. A crib too?
No, I didn't say a mil. You did.
Okay, so what do I get?
You said a mil. You said the crib and the whip.
And a residual income of 10k a month for 24 months.
You're down.
So honestly,
speaking of this, let's go on some greater topics. V-Man was on CBC News helping the youth of our community.
To switch combos like that is crazy.
That's crazy because we were going too deep into it. And then V-Man was actually at a school program helping kids.
I saw that video still.
Yeah, it's pretty dope, man.
It's a great experience for me, man.
Yeah. So what exactly did you do other than CPR?
No, we're
oh my God!
Yeah, that's actually why. Sorry.
I'm not even going to laugh.
I shouldn't have said that.
Knowing Ruben, he's going to cut that up.
It was like a bunch of like preschool kids, like a bunch of paramedics were kind of showing and telling the ambulance, showing them, asking them, "Oh, what number do you call if you need an emergency or not?" Like,
it's what just, if a kid said 647?
So what did you say? 411? No.
Huh?
No, yeah.
411. And obviously, just showing. It was just nice.
That's actually a big move for you.
Yeah.
I'm proud of you,
like,
man.
For me, like, I feel like that segue is what I want to eventually get into, like that teaching aspect.
Oh, I thought you wanted to be on CBC News.
No. Yeah, that's like, yo.
That teaching aspect, because I feel like, yo, like.
You want to teach people about ambulances?
Yeah.
That's like, kind of dope.
You know, you'd be a good teacher.
I feel like I would.
I think you'd be a great teacher.
Yeah.
Especially when you go, yeah.
For the kid,
yeah. That's how you're going to do it.
But
to switch everything up.
Yeah. Okay.
But B, finish your sentence.
No, it was a great experience. So, like, I feel like.
Big moves.
Yeah.
It was actually pretty big. I thought you were acting the whole time. I didn't know you were a paramedic. Then I'm like, oh, fuck.
Low key.
Yeah, I went on the ambulance van doctor.
Only my close people know. Now you guys know too.
Yeah, the world
that's
knows.
That's cap, bro.
What do you mean? We talked about it on the first episode of the first season.
Yeah, but no one knows like that, like you guys know.
Oh, right. Okay. Sure.
No, I agree.
Yeah. But you know who needs some oxygen and some CPR? Our guy, Bronny James.
Yo, come on, pun intended.
That's crazy, fam.
Yeah, bro. Oh, bro, I didn't think about that. That's actually wild, man. That's not what I meant. That's crazy.
That's
but yo.
Oh my God.
But yo, 2 points a game. Points a game is not.
No. Let's just stop for a second. Yeah.
Yo, that's.
That's actually wild.
You gotta knock on wood
for
that.
That's not what I meant, but you know.
Yeah. I know that's not what you meant, but honestly, I had high hopes for him.
Same.
But honestly,
it's too early to tell, you think?
I think it is too early to tell.
I agree, just because the type of trainers and the attention and the work he's going to be able to put in with having like the greatest player ever as his dad and the coaches, everybody
as his teammate, wants... It's been his dad.
Like they want him to succeed. Yeah. So I feel like as long as he puts in the work, he'll succeed. And I also think him playing this bad means he's way better than this.
Yeah. Yeah. You can only get better from this.
Because take this in, like, he's playing so bad that you're like, what the fuck? This guy is not this ass.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, you can't be this bad.
I mean, I think
like,
it's a...
Like, he's averaging like 6 air balls a game.
No.
No, not 6 air balls a game.
No, no, but yo...
He's shooting poorly, but one thing that is a positive
He's also very undersized, fam.
One positive takeaway is on defense, like, yo, you know he's
going... Lockdown.
Like, he's trying...
No, I saw a bunch of videos of him getting cooked.
Actually?
There's like 2 plays where he's getting cooked.
No, no, other
than that, like, he's playing...
He's a pretty good 3-point shooter, but he hasn't been able to make one yet.
No, but I think it's because he's in a slump right now. Yeah. Like, I feel like he even said it himself, I'm in a slump. And like I said, I feel like if he was playing average, where he was average, he was shooting like 30%, like shooting like 40%, then you'd be like, yeah, maybe this is him.
No,
you know, he's shooting so bad that he could only get better from this.
I think the main
thing, he can't be this bad.
Yeah. The main thing we're forgetting,
he would not be NBA if he was this bad.
When it comes to basketball, it's not just pure skill. Constantly. It's also a big mental game.
Yeah, 100%.
And the way all, you know, sports channels are attacking this guy, all the memes coming out, bro, it's a lot outside of basketball to kind of, you know, even as much as you're trying to put this noise behind you, bro, it's going to get to you eventually.
The scrutiny that he's getting.
It's insane. I don't think I've seen it like that.
Pick and you're being talked on ESPN First Take.
It's the Bron effect, man.
It's the Bron effect. I mean, that's crazy. First of all, you're going to play for LA, so that you're going to hear on a regular basis.
Yeah. No,
secondly, you're LeBron's son.
You're not getting talked about like that.
You're LeBron's son.
The guy that got drafted first round last year.
Yeah.
What's his name?
Who?
The guy that got drafted last year first round.
Wemby?
No.
Hoshifino?
The guy that got drafted first round to the Lakers last year. See what I mean?
Yeah, I don't even know who that is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's what I mean. You don't even talk about the first round picks of Lakers.
Yeah.
Who like was their first round pick? Did they even have one?
Wasn't it Jalen Hood-Shifino?
Yeah, that guy. He was doo-doo too.
Oh, jeez.
No. Yo, you know who's going crazy though? The guy out of Scarborough that's on the Wolves. He dropped like 23 and 14.
Yeah, he was cooking.
I hooped with him a while back.
Yeah.
He was nice.
His motor is different though. Yeah. Like the way he's running up and down.
Yeah. He's also very ambidextrous.
Screw that, guys. The main event right now is the Olympics basketball. Yeah. Paris.
Yeah, should we go?
Would be nice, but I think getting tickets for that would be almost next to impossible.
Sneak in like they did in Copa America.
Steph had a nice game today.
Steph had an amazing game.
Yeah, really? Played Serbia.
Yo, because he played super ass, like...
Yeah, the first 2 games, he was non-existent.
Was bad.
Yeah.
Like 1 for 13.
Yeah. I mean, they're also, I don't know if you noticed, but every game there's a new starting lineup other than Steph and LeBron.
No, but fam, I'm going to tell you this. This is actually exposing Steve Kerr as a horrible coach. He's been doing it with Golden State. No one's taking in how bad of a coach he actually is.
No,
I don't think he's a bad coach
fam,
at all.
He is a horrible coach.
Why do you say he's horrible?
Fam, he does not know. He doesn't make good changes.
No, so right now,
his lineup
right now,
it's just what?
Yeah, but they're also doing that because they're trying to figure out who the final lineup is going to be when they get to the Olympics. Yeah, right now, it's just play full matches.
Golden State and how horrible he actually is.
And Golden State, yeah, his adjustments.
And that actually.
No, he's got pretty good adjustments. Come on, guys.
Some
man's got 4 chips. I know he's got 6 players, but like, he's not a bad coach. We know who bad coaches are.
He adopted a system from someone that system that wasn't his and had a great run. If you really take it in, the first year, Bron had nobody win 6 games.
Yeah.
Right? Second year, they choked. Third year, you have KD for another 2 years.
Yeah. KD's injured. He's not even playing right now.
Yeah, he's not
playing. Right. I think they're trying to save him for the actual games.
Is the best player on the Olympic team? Not the greatest, the best.
The best player, I think, Anthony Edwards.
I think it's Steph Curry still.
I think it's that too.
Yeah, I mean, Steph had some weak games for a few games, but
he's
been consistent, exactly.
And, like, yeah. You see
and he's been fun to watch.
Every time he gets the ball, like he's
cooking the guy.
Yeah.
Yo, but I'm telling you, when the Olympics actually starts, you're going to see that Steph is the best player on the court.
Oh, 100%. Yeah. I mean, when it's game time and it's go time, you know, Steph is going to show up like that. We're not downplaying.
Embiid. I don't know.
Yo, the man are saying like he's trying to foul bait.
Yeah.
But he's also moving like he's injured. They should start AD over Embiid.
AD's been 6 blocks.
Yeah, crazy.
6 blocks.
Yo, people were talking about like Serbia winning this game. Bro,
yeah,
Serbia
all those guys on ESPN were stroking Serbia fam. They're like, that's the best team.
Because of Joker.
They're like, Joker sat there watching the USA almost lose to Australia and Joker was ready.
Yeah.
He knows their weakness. He's going to attack them in the paint. They got slapped.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And they were also coming out to win against France too. They pretty much slapped France. So obviously France are one of the top teams. So all the commentators are probably like, yo,
fam, they all try to create these unrealistic hypes about the USA maybe losing. They're not going
to
lose.
They're not losing. Oh, bro, they're going to smash every team. They have at least minimum 20 to 30 Steph, points.
KD.
Crazy.
AD. Yeah. Embiid. Tatum. They're, Anthony. Yo. Like.
Thanks. You can go on ESPN and see the starting lineup.
The type of players like that, you can put it anywhere.
Yeah,
you
but want that's Team USA for the last 70 years.
No, they lost last year.
Yeah, yeah. But that wasn't the Olympics.
Yeah, but they lost last year.
Yeah, that wasn't this team.
No, but what I'm trying to tell you, no, but you said that's that.
It's only the Olympics that all the guys show up. They don't show up for a FIBA World Championship or shit like that.
Canada also has a good team, though.
Yeah, oh well.
Yeah, I think Canada has
Yeah, but no one really focuses on
we
Canada.
We have a great backcourt in Shea and Jamal.
That's it. I think that's
Other than that, like the team is doo-doo.
It's good on paper, just not them, something I would watch.
They also have the toughest pool, too. They have Greece, they have Spain, I think, in their pool, too.
Who's on Greece?
Giannis. It's Giannis and his brothers. But what's bigger than the Olympics
Giannis
right now?
Giannis is so good, he can beat that. Well,
international events is bigger than the Olympics.
You tell us.
We got invited, but we couldn't go.
No, we got invited for the pre-events, not the main event. Okay, yeah.
Ambani Wedding.
Crazy. This is still going? Dude, it's like a season after and this is still happening.
I swear it's been going on as long as we've been off. Like, 7 months.
That's crazy.
Honestly, like seeing that wedding, I'm like, low-key, we could have somehow snuck in.
Yeah.
If we got there.
It seemed a little easy.
If you just dress super nice and be like, oh shit, I forgot my pass.
Yeah, but I think everyone's talking about Kim Kardashian and the red outfit. Between us, what did you guys think of the whole look?
I didn't see the look.
Oh, you didn't?
Yeah.
I seen the look.
Super bad?
I didn't mind the look, but I was...
I think it was a little too much for that crowd.
It was too much, but it's also like, yo, she wasn't even putting in no effort. There was a video saying how she put a music on her story.
I saw that.
And it was
you
like,
search Indian music the first.
Indian music up and the first track is the track she used. So it's like,
I felt bad for.
I saw Rajinikanth there though.
Well, Rajinikanth was moving.
And he was dancing.
I sent you the video.
Oh, yeah, he was just dancing like
Shout out to my guy Rajini though.
Surya was there.
Surya was there.
Surya was there. Rajini was there.
I didn't see too.
Shah Rukh Khan. I mean, Madhavan was there too. I think.
Madhavan was there.
Actually, there was a lookalike. It wasn't him.
Yeah. But yo, that event just been going, eh? Yeah. Justin Bieber performed.
Because when. Beginning of season two.
No, but you know what it is?
Rihanna performed for that one.
No, you know what it is? I feel like the wedding was a day, but people are posting it for months and months because it was probably the biggest wedding in the world.
No. For this one, it was actually a bunch of events leading into the wedding.
That's crazy.
So it was like nonstop.
Yeah, but you know what I like about the Ambani family? Like, if you look at them, they look very genuine.
No, they don't. They look fake as fuck. Stop.
You see the guy walking with the girl? The girl looks like low-key, you can see that she married into the money out. But like,
let me
bro, they all look like they hate each other, man.
Pause. Yo, she is just as much as up as him.
Yeah, 100%.
Yeah, you were telling me that, right?
Just we talked about it. But like, as up as Ambani family.
No, not as much. She's up.
Up.
Yeah. No, but you can't be as much as no one's close to Ambani. But men's worth $132 billion.
Yeah.
So they were talking about, you know, the performance that they paid Justin Bieber. I think they paid him like $8 to $10 million.
Yes.
And they were doing the math in terms of his value to how much you paid Justin Bieber. And they were comparing it to like 0.0008%. Yeah. And when you compare it to a regular American or a regular human being, that's like the price of a latte for us.
A
price of a latte at Starbucks. So him getting Justin Bieber to perform is him paying for a latte.
Yo, to get up like that, you gotta give it to them, Ambani.
Bro, that's crazy. That's insane.
But also, like,
because that puts I'll see the money in perspective, fam.
Bro, that's crazy.
Yo, man, bought a latte. And that's
just they'll come out bro. Dressed in like jewels. But the difference between them dressing in jewels and the ones we see in the Tamil weddings here is they're actually wearing real diamonds.
Yeah.
On their dresses. Their dresses cost like $25 million.
But the thing is, Tamils don't like diamonds, bro. They like their 22, 24 karat gold. They don't really mess with diamonds.
No, but you'll see these Tamil girls wearing jewels in their saris, you know? But those people are rocking some real ones.
Anyone in specifically you guys liked in terms of fits?
I saw Priyanka Chopra, is that her name? Dancing?
Dancing? I mean, she's always dancing. They were all dancing.
Nick something?
Yeah, Nick Jonas.
Yeah. To be honest, I wasn't really feeling any fits like that.
I wasn't really paying attention like that.
I was just paying attention to like who showed up.
That's it, yeah.
Like everyone that's booming in.
You know who didn't show up? Kamalasen. Because he made that shit movie called Indian 2.
I actually haven't watched
Bro, the reviews for Indian 2.
Trash.
Oh my gosh,
I didn't even watch Indian 1.
Bro, you know how with our movies, they always try to make a sequel to the movie, but the sequel never ends up being like the classic? Yeah. Remember when I told you guys Indian was probably the best storyline ever created in Tamil history? The first one?
No.
You've never watched the first one? No. Oh, come on, bro.
What is it about?
You have to watch it. It's one of the greatest storylines ever as well. Next to Dilvin.
Did you pretend to be a president or something?
No, no, no. This is him returning as a 106-year-old grandpa because he was the grandpa in the first Indian. Okay. He was the father of Kamala Singh, but they were both...
The
Indian Tata. Yeah. But bro, the reviews on this one, they're saying that Shankar lost everything. It's actually a horrible movie according to the reviews, and I'm not even going to go watch it based on these reviews because the last time I heard reviews like that is when one horrible movie came out and we were just...
Like Varus? The only thing sick about Varus was the house.
Yeah.
The house.
Outside of that, I think the house did better acting than most of these guys. Yeah, and it's just that there. But
the brothers were horrible in that
movie. The brothers were bad.
Bro, screw those guys. But another movie I put you guys on, and you guys obviously watched it, Gutterden.
That was dope.
Crazy. That's on Prime, guys. Watch it. I think we talked about it last time.
No,
for him to transition from being a comedian to like the main actor.
Insane.
Yeah.
Insane.
Yo, but I realize when comedians do that, they do a good job.
No. That never happens.
Remember who's Buddy Bill's movie where he's the main actor?
Oh, No, there was a sicker one. Remember it was like a king movie.
A king.
That's the one.
What's
it called?
Pugliese.
There's a Pugliese 1, 2, 3. Yeah.
Bro, anytime a comedian turns into a hero or starts making movies, it's garbage. Yeah, they've never succeeded.
Well, you know why it's garbage?
This one was fire.
You know why it's garbage? I know why it's garbage. It's because they put like a love story twist, but this was just like raw.
This is raw gangster shit. Yeah. Another movie that's been trending and I've been telling people they've been watching, but everyone's coming out with their
good review. I haven't watched it yet.
Maharaja, Vijay Sethupathi on Netflix. Guys, if you haven't watched it, Maharaja is the movie to watch. I think it's probably the best movie I've seen in the last 2 years.
Really?
That's insane, bro. Like, honestly, it's gonna hit so many.
You said that about the other movie too. It's the best movie you've ever seen in like 5 years.
I can't lie. I can't trust your opinions so much. You've been saying it for Gutterden.
You watch it like
I can literally pull up screenshots right now that you said literally Gutterden. You're like, yo, I haven't watched a movie like
Gutterden. Yeah. No, you idiots. I said Gutterden is the best movie, but I'm still waiting for Maharaja to come out. Good try.
You did not just say that.
Every other movie I put you guys on, you guys loved. Don't even cap right now. What's the other movie I said was the best?
Yeah, clearly you don't even know.
Yo, Maharaja, crazy movie.
Which movie was sick? Bad Boys 2.
Yo, I'll tell you what.
I didn't watch it.
Whatever. Bad Boys 4.
Bad Boys is the first one.
Yeah. No, the newest one.
Talk about it. I heard it's crazy. Talk about weddings.
I heard it's the best one.
Talk about weddings. Yeah. I think it's the best one.
Yeah.
I've watched it.
Actually, it's the best one.
Why were you laughing?
You know what movie was super ass though? That I was kind of hyped for, but it was ass?
What?
Quiet Place 2. The Quiet Place.
Origin or something.
Right? Bro, it was so ass. Like, I was so confused.
I've actually never heard of the movie.
It was so quiet.
The Quiet Place was so good.
The first two were good.
With John Krasinski and Emily.
Yo, but talking about weddings and Ambani weddings, and you shoot a lot of the Ambani Toronto weddings. Like, do you guys think the cost of the Tamil weddings have been going crazy?
Insane, bro. Bro, the thing is, the South Asian community specifically are
getting called?
Getting called for sure. Every vendor could charge whatever price they want. Yeah. You have no choice but to pay because you don't have that many of the same vendors.
Yeah. And the dates.
Yeah. You know, these priests will... I'm not attacking any priests here, but...
Yeah.
I feel like they only give you dates that they're going to be available for.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Because, no, take this.
Controversial topic.
Take this in.
Going on here.
Whoa. Take this in.
Dream Factory.
So let's say your parents are going to meet a priest to get a date. Yeah. You meet with three priests. Three priests give you three different dates.
Yeah.
Whoa. How? If they're all working on the same date, why are you getting three different dates from three different priests?
Yeah.
And I'm saying they're going to go based on what they're available for.
So
and
is give that you the what happened to you?
So, yeah, it happened to me as well. And then I'm like, I need an evening wedding.
Yeah.
I just snuck another $100 bill.
You're lying.
I'm kidding. No, but...
See, he's like, Sami, $100 bill.
No, people actually take that very seriously. But I think in terms of the wedding, I think the minimum wedding cost right now in the Tamil community...
Like, including reception.
I think it's not including reception. Reception's a whole different ballgame.
Fam, with reception, you're hitting 100.
Easy.
You're hitting 100 for sure.
Easy.
Yeah, 100?
100.
100 for like the type of reception you've been seeing. Yeah. Even though the receptions have come down in recent years.
Like a reception where you're not invited, you're not going crazy. You're like...
That's...
Weddings right now, I think, are a minimum of $40,000. That's not including the dolly that you're buying. Or that's the not, ring. Or the ring.
Because we're Western and Sri Lankan
I for think some reason. The, we don't the average, get the dollies. The average per head right now for a Hindu ceremony, like keep in mind there's no meat for that. Hawk Tuah! And I think it's at a minimum of either, you know, $70 to $80.
So do you want
to... The price that used to be for these type of weddings were $20 to $30.
Yeah.
And that's obviously the 70 to 80 is on the higher end because that's what everyone's doing right now, the setups.
When you say 20 to 25, what year was that?
I would say like 4 years, right before COVID.
Yeah.
Like 2016, 2014.
Yeah, like I think $20 to $40 was the going price for
so,
that.
So a wedding that's extravagant in 2014.
How not much not including the hall no, fees. Yeah.
Wedding, reception, everything.
100K.
2014.
100K.
2014.
100K.
2014 was 100K?
Sorry, no, 2014, no, sorry, 2024.
What do you think people would spend in 2014?
Yeah, they're still spending a lot, bro. Like, you already know how talent people spend on their weddings. They go all out.
Mm-hmm. You probably spent a lot during your wedding.
Like, you think people would spend, like, 100K back then, too? Like, 2016?
I'm sure a few of them did it, but it wasn't the norm.
Yeah.
Like, now, I think it's a standard.
Now, if you do both. Why it's weird is people are saving up for weddings and shit, yeah. Right?
My question to you guys is, knowing the price range we're doing, in terms of weddings and reception, would you rather spend that towards your reception or save the money and go try to buy a house? But then you realize the money that you're saving to buy a house is not even enough to buy a house. Yeah. So what do?
So then you go buy a mouse.
And you're looking at like when you invite these people to the weddings, you're also paying for the reception. So you look at it per head.
So I think like
200 or like
to kind of slow everything down, you should just charge people to come to your wedding.
No, but the thing is, like, I love the people that are doing small, intimate receptions with just the friends.
Bro, that's the vibe.
It's such a vibe. Like,
that's
that.
The best thing.
Shout out to Tanuja and Gautam that did a small, intimate wedding at a barn reception. Bro, it was the best so time. Yeah. Everyone had a great time.
But why do you have receptions? Yo, bro, the Tamil community is confusing, fam. Your wedding will have, like, 700 people of people you've never met. Yeah.
No, but that's the thing.
That makes no freaking sense.
Then I've been to receptions, like Casper's saying, you'll have 500 people there. Yeah. But by 11 o'clock, there's no dance floor.
Exactly.
So you've invited some of the older folks to come see what the was going on. But it's actually, to me, I find it weird because you have this many people. Your dance floor is done around 10, 11. But like these other reception with just your friends and stuff, bro, 2 or 3 a.m. are still asking for more songs.
Like if I was to do a wedding, fam, it'll be overseas.
Yeah.
It'll just be my family, my friends.
Yeah.
When I say my family, it's people I've met. If it's my mom's cousin's sister and I have not met her, she's not coming to my wedding.
Yeah.
My family, my friends, the girl's family, her friends, and her family, right? It has to be like a very intimate wedding following a ceremony at the same time.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
overseas.
Yeah.
And that'll make sure that my closest people come.
Yeah.
If my closest people can afford it, I'll pay for them. Yeah. They can come out. But I'm not doing these big, extravagant $200,000 Canadian weddings.
It's not worth it.
It's not worth it. You're spending $200K for one day.
For one people to come party it up for one day, and then you go back home, and then you realize that you know a lot of the relationships don't work due to finance, because you just went into debt to pay this wedding, and then now you're like, what do I do?
But you know what's even weird?
Or you go into the wedding thinking that you're gonna make a lot of the money back with the gifts you're getting from your friends and family, and then you realize it didn't even cut half.
It doesn't even cut half.
Like a family of five only gives you like $300.
The worst, bro.
$100,
fam. I'm not going at anyone, but like family of five dropped
$50.
25 or $50.
Okay, that's American fried.
Plus. Yeah, see, that's sharp.
Well, like, if you're going to show up to a wedding, guys, minimum, I think, is 100 to 150.
Yeah.
Whether you,
I'll say now
as a couple, the minimum of 150, today's day and age, if you're not going to drop a minimum 150, okay, we're not even, like, saying, oh, we're balling or anything like that, but I think, out of respect for the couple you're going to,
you know what's funny?
Because if you're not going to do that, don't go to that wedding.
Yeah. You know what's actually jokes? The first wedding I actually ever went to, like, it was Suren's wedding. I don't know, you have to give money and shit.
Oh, yeah.
You
showed up in the LV shirt, right?
No, I didn't.
No.
Oh, you came here from the casino.
No, he came with that Gucci shirt.
I came, and that was my first wedding. I'm like, oh, what the fuck? Yo, looking back, I'm like, that was Suren's wedding.
Yeah, Suren's wedding.
That's now crazy. That I'm thinking about, I'm like, what the?
Yeah.
I remember I got there, and then every man had an envelope with their names on it.
Yeah. And you were asking us.
You know what's also super L? If you go to a wedding, but the man doesn't invite you to the reception, that's an even bigger L.
Bro.
That's fried.
That's actually wild.
That's
super. I could actually recollect one person that did that to us.
Maybe he couldn't. I didn't even get invited to the wedding.
No, true.
At least for me, it's like, be straight up with it, you know? Like, don't try to, like, beat around the bush.
No, but the thing is, like, don't do that because you want to make money at your wedding, but you then not disrespect the man's by not inviting to reception. But, yo, to each his own.
To each your own, you know?
Like, yeah, if that's what you want to do, that's what you want to do.
Yeah, because you know what it is, too? Like, I feel like these Tamil weddings are getting out of hand.
Out of hand.
Right? Two, you're going to recoup money. It's not going to be 20% of the whole value. Because you don't know what people are going to bring. Yeah. So don't start calculating something and...
Don't do, oh, I'm going to have 200 people, on average $100 per person.
And then,
yeah.
You know,
yeah.
It's like, not... Do it for the right reasons, but also at the same time, like, don't go beyond your means just to appease.
Because, yo, and yo, this is, sorry, this is what I want to bring up, but I kind of forgot for a second.
Yeah.
Bro, I'm tired of the same reception tactics. The couple comes in, the grooms come running, the girls come running, a dance move, like, bro, it's so boring.
Fam. Yeah. I mean, if you could think of a different strategy, let us know. But that's going to be the strategy going forward.
No, I feel like it's such a boring.
That's lit.
No,
I love it.
Yeah, no, I don't. I think it's.
You don't like it? What would you do for your reception? Like, you would just already be in the hall when people come
in? No. You know, fam. So it's a party to come celebrate. You walk in, we say a speech.
So, which is what they're doing right now?
Yeah, you walk in.
The speech is what they're doing right now.
You walk in. When I say you walk in, I'm not saying people are standing there. And I'm walking in while people are there.
Okay.
We come to the venue.
Everyone walks in together?
Together. You have the apps time, like you do here.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
But then...
So far, everything you said is what's happening right now.
No, it's not. That's not what happens.
Cocktail hour.
No, no. I'll tell you what happens now.
Okay.
You stand outside the hall for 2 hours.
Cocktail hour.
Right? Then, everybody else walks in and waits for you. Yeah. Then you start doing some dramatic exchanges. Things and things about to walk in. And then they walk in.
So what would you do instead of that?
I would walk into the venue with all my
people. Oh, with all your guests in the cocktail. Okay.
Like, the cocktail hour would be with me and my peoples.
Okay.
We would celebrate that.
Yeah, but that's right? What you're doing at the reception.
That's what you're doing during cocktail hour, fam.
But the couple's not there.
The couple is there, Jake.
No, they're not.
No, not really.
Really?
No.
Yeah, you don't know, so don't speak.
Okay, go ahead. What else?
Yeah, they're not there. They're not there. So I would walk in, celebrate the cocktail hour, right? I wouldn't go... sit on a stage while my people are down there. It would just be like a nice little seating, you know, like you know, like those nice...
So where would you sit?
Like, I would say, like, there's a bunch of tables.
Yeah. You would have your own... Like, you would sit at a table.
It would be like, the not a stage, but like the table at the front.
Yeah, that's still considered a stage.
No, it's not.
Yeah.
The table
at the front. If you do it at the hall, they would always have a stage.
No,
if you do it at a hall. Okay, so if you do it, you will still have to be center.
One, I wouldn't do it at a hall.
Okay.
If I even did it at all, I wouldn't be... on a stage.
Okay.
I think what's nice is the cake cutting.
Yeah.
Celebrating that.
Yeah.
Followed by some intimate speeches of my two closest people.
Mm-hmm.
You go eat. Dance floor opens. You party till the end of the day. There's no my groomsmen running in. The girls running in. Playing some
this
weird
is,
game.
I think Casper's...
That's how...
Casper's way of saying you guys are not going to be groomsmen. Yeah. You guys sit at a table at cocktail hour.
No. My groom... I'm still going to have groomsmen. But I'm just not going to have... the groomsmen running in doing a dance versus the girls thing. I'm also not going to have a guy there with a mic talking for everything.
But you need an MC.
You don't, fam. You actually don't.
Trust me. Trust me.
You do need
an MC. Yo, trust me. No. An event without an MC is an absolute nightmare.
How are you going to make your groomsmen feel like they're exclusive, part of something that you're going to be talking
buddy,
about
it's for my
the rest
wedding.
Of
your
life, fam?
Yeah.
We just come to
so why have groomsmen?
You guys are there with me partying.
Everyone else is partying.
But we can come as regular guests and do that.
Yeah,
so come as regular guests and do that.
Okay, so that's your plan.
No, but you know what I'm saying? Like, yo, fam, you got to take in...
The groomsmen are there to...
I'm telling you, this only happens in the Tamil community. If you watch other people's weddings...
It happens in every damn community. Bro, there's a groomsman thing for me.
I went to an African wedding.
Which box are you living in?
Way different.
African weddings are different, though.
It was way different.
Yeah.
Like, it was so intimate. It was so fun.
Okay, so honestly, I don't want to take this... I don't want to take this story from you because your first wedding was Seren's wedding.
Yeah.
Right?
First Tamil wedding.
Okay.
First Tamil
wedding. Now you're going to compare all these weddings to the one African wedding you went to.
When
I'm telling you, this is a standard...
I went to an African wedding and I went to an Italian.
Sorry, man. I'm gonna have to disagree with that.
I went to an African wedding and Italian wedding. Fam, they did not seem like they were putting on a show for the peoples.
Yeah.
It just felt intimate.
Okay.
I'm being serious.
Intimate is different.
Yeah.
Yes. Intimate
literally,
is gonna be intimate.
That's what I'm trying to say.
But for you to say no MC, no. Without an MC, any
sure,
event
sure
is a nightmare.
Sure you can have an MC.
Yeah.
Still no, like, yo.
You just don't like the whole groomsman running in.
No, not the groomsman coming in.
The bridesmaids.
Like, it's the same thing. The girl's mom and dad walks in. The guy... Fam,
so,
going
like,
to all these weddings, it's like there's no originality, fam.
Mm-hmm. So what would you do for your mom and dad to walk
They're
in.
They're already there.
Yeah, so you don't care, you don't want to give them like special attention or anything.
Why would I have, fam? It's a wedding.
Yeah.
Like what the? I'm so confused.
Yo,
so
the wedding is.
Yeah, like yo, no, I'm
but
so
the thing
confused.
Is,
that's what you want.
That's yeah, like,
fine. That's fine. What you know what?
Yeah. Because you're fam, if you watch every reception video, it's the same thing.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Every wedding is gonna be the same. Every Hindu wedding is gonna be the same.
No, no, that's what
it's
I'm trying to say.
It's been the same for centuries.
No, no, that's what I'm trying to say. Yeah. Like,
it's, I mean, it's what you're saying out. Is nice. You just like you just want an intimate wedding.
Yeah, I just want it to be like it's a celebration.
I mean, you could do
if we learn from other cultures, we'd also be saving bare cash, fam.
There's no, but
you know what I'm saying.
Right. A lot of even you look at white people, they do the same thing. You look at black people, they do the same thing. African weddings, sure, they might be a little different based off of certain practices.
No, but I see what he means. He's talking more of like the intimate side of the thing.
Because you're the type of guy you don't care to have like. All the glitz and glamour, like you
No, he does.
Like just
but not in an intimate way.
Yeah, like it's just not like
I don't
a
know
show.
How he's supposed to have the glitz and glamour. He's,
yeah, I mean Casper, if anyone could do it, it's him.
Jeez.
All right. Now we're in the summer. You're going to Tulum next week. How do you feel about traveling in the summer when it's summer in Toronto, to another summer destination?
Summer in Toronto is not really a thing.
You don't think so?
I don't think.
Lit, but
yeah,
also traveling.
I will
summer,
travel in the summer too, fam. Nice. Like summer, winter, like I don't think it's a big difference. But I, obviously you'll be in the city more often.
Would you rather travel maybe in the off season so you could go get the summer somewhere else?
I don't
or
really
no?
care.
You don't care for it?
Yeah.
I would love that too. Because I would hate to travel between June and July when it's hot here. Because you don't get much of a summer in Toronto.
Yeah.
And the second you come back and you're already in the fall season. So
yeah, but recently though, the weather has been good in terms of like we don't really get heavy winters. Like this winter wasn't even bad.
Winter's been great.
Yeah.
Summer started early for us. We've had some hot days,
we have
minus some of the rain.
Hot days in February.
I think we've had some of the hotter days in years.
We were actually, like,
global warming is real.
Yeah.
What?
Global warming is real, he said.
Yeah, 100%.
It's mad real. I mean, I hope you have fun in Tulum, bro. Any plans for traveling for you?
I got Uma's reception.
Yeah.
Where are you going?
August, Cancun.
Ooh.
My first time in Cancun, I haven't been to Mexico yet.
Oh, no way. Oh, you've been to DR, not Mexico. Yeah, Cancun's party city, man.
Yo, what's the
Which resort are you staying?
What's it called?
Sorry?
What's the Cancun of DR?
Punta Cana?
Oh, okay. Yeah.
I don't know.
I remember, do you guys remember in high school there was a trip, like you go on?
S-trip.
Yeah, I couldn't afford it.
So. Oh, I don't even think I had one.
You know what's funny? Nobody told me that there was payment plans.
Yeah. No way.
Yeah, like you start
back then?
The start of the year, you pay like a deposit, then you pay it off slowly by the end of the year.
Yeah.
But I also never had my passport in high school, so I couldn't have went anyways.
Also,
that would have been a problem.
For all the kids that your parents are not don't have enough funds, you can go talk to the teacher and say, can I apply for financial aid?
If you apply for financial aid to go on S trip, you're fucked.
Not S trip, but like yo, like just
this guy's like, hi nice. Miss, I need financial aid to go on the S trip to get
just go to
obviously,
your room.
Obviously, like we're like
because I heard some crazy stories about S trip.
My experience in high school is like we had a trip to Boston. Obviously, my parents are now giving me $600.
Yo,
to go to
there's
Boston
no
for
way
five
you
days.
Went to the Boston Tea Party.
No.
That's crazy.
And then so I went to talk to my teacher. I'm like, yeah, I really want to go. Like. Like, is there a way you can help me out? She's like, yeah, just write me a letter. Like,
and she'll pay for
it? As to why. And then so I wrote her like a whole page letter and then they submitted it into the...
She's the one that got caught.
The school. And then, yeah.
I remember I saw her on the news.
Yeah.
But wait, there's ways around it. If you really want to go...
Just write your teacher a letter and then she'll get charged for...
I mean, you got advice from two of the greatest. Something crazy happened not too long ago.
Many men.
Many.
Honestly,
bro, they had a meme.
Yeah,
where
Boston.
Yo,
50 was at Boston.
No, man. They had a meme right now of Donald Trump walking out to that song. And they made it seem like they were playing that song while he was walking out. That was crazy.
That was crazy.
Shout out Trump, man. That guy literally dodged the bullet.
I saw a video and it was like, he was literally like, the guy shot straight and Donald Trump went like this.
Yeah.
Guys, can I ask you something?
I think it's staged.
Stage?
I think
it's staged.
Yo, no, the thing is this. The two things. I think it's either staged or that the Secret Service actually wanted him dead, but the guy missed.
Yeah. No, I think it was
staged.
Because
there's no way a guy walked up on us on the roof, set up a rifle.
Yeah, makes no sense.
And they missed.
They missed.
The crowd saw the shooter before the police saw the shooter.
Bro, there's a video of the exact same angle.
Right, he's right there.
No,
yeah.
There's a video of the exact same angle where there was a lady holding the sign.
Yeah, and then she dropped the sign and took out the camera.
And took out the camera right away. She lifted the sign up and down a few times. The shots go up. She puts the sign down and she starts recording right away.
Meanwhile, everyone behind her is like...
Everyone's like, yeah. This is crazy.
Oh, she's so smiling. Calm. Yeah. I saw that.
What
they said she was in on it or something.
Yeah.
But I don't know.
Or like she was part of like the planning. But
imagine
I'm so dumb.
Like He actually got shot.
I'm telling you right now, guys, Donald Trump will be the next president of the United States.
I think again. He's a good president, fam. I think he'll be better than Biden. Like, people don't understand. Like, they keep blaming Donald Trump. Like, he wasn't a bad president.
For financially, and the economy of the world was better with Donald Trump.
Yeah.
Obviously oh people God. Did the divide in terms of, like, the racist card and all of that. I mean, it was at an all-time high.
The MAGA movement and everything like
that. But I think as a president himself, he did a far better job than Joe Biden right now.
Biden, I don't even think he's a person right now.
I don't even think he's...
That's happening. He called Ukrainian President Putin.
Yeah, no, he's confused.
Yeah, like, I actually think there's something mentally going on. There's obviously someone
behind. No, bro, he's just too old.
I know, that's what I'm saying. Like, he's not mentally stable enough to...
To run a country.
Because the way he's walking up the stairs and stuff.
The man called Kamala Harris Trump.
Yeah, I know.
Literally, like, what the fuck are we doing? Yeah.
And there's a video of him, I'll show you Casper, there's a video of him riding the bike. He stopped and he just fell.
He also said that the next best job available for black people in the States was the vice president role.
Yeah.
No, see, this is fucked. This is, you know, crazy. What? I think he's the president. I think there's people behind the scenes controlling him.
That's what I said.
Yeah. I mean, that's most politicians. Yeah, yeah, they're just a puppet to the show.
Yeah.
Let's not talk about our prime minister here.
Yeah.
And he's where nice. Our life has been in the last few years has been a complete shit show.
Even our mayor.
I think they're all hand in hand, trash this place.
I think we should cut it off.
Cut it off.
Yeah, we're going too long.
Too long.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's finish with the forget brown genetics.
No, not even the worst brown food. We'll leave it for next week.
Next week?
Yeah. Okay. Let's just now go into the closing.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm going to talk about for the closing real quickly.
No, don't worry. So, yeah, man. So that's been a crazy shit with the American politics. Yeah.
No, but even the American politics rolls into ours. Like, our country's been super ass.
Yeah, we're affected. Yeah, we're affected immediately.
Fried the whole country.
Yeah, everything that U.S. does, we follow suit pretty much.
Yeah, 100%. Yeah. Like, anything that happens to your economy, whatever the case may be, it's immediate.
Like, how is it better to live in the U.S. than here?
No. Yeah, it's actually better to live in the U.S. than here right now. And that's actually crazy, sad that we're actually saying that right now.
People used to be like, we want to go to Canada.
Yeah.
Getting into Canada was hard. Yeah. Now, it's like everybody's trying to leave. You know?
Crazy, man.
Who's not leaving?
The Brodies. Let's go.
Today, honestly, today was crazy.
Today was crazy.
He got me with the left.
My bad, boys. But one more thing, right before we wrap it up, Brodies Brunch is something we've been working on.
Yeah, we're talking about it.
We might have a Brodies Brunch talking about it for an event.
Location to be determined.
Determined for an end of summer event. Yeah. We'd love to meet a lot of you. At this event, let us know if it's something you'd be interested in.
We'll make a poll on Instagram or something.
Why not turn up with the Brodies? You know, mimosas and things.
Brunch. We're gonna have some. We're gonna
chicken
have
and waffles. I love. Beer. I love
shirts, sweaters.
Oh yeah, I forgot we had that.
Yeah, I mean, it's been in the pipeline for a hot minute.
Imagine just chicken delivered. And waffles though. It'd be super.
I mean, I think we're working on a little menu as well.
You know, we got the best DJ in the city, DJ Cal. She's probably gonna come and help spin for us.
Oh, 100%. So check out Brodies Brunch. It's something we're working on. Coming to a location near you, probably in the East End, for like everything else. But with that being said, guys,
thank wrap you guys.
Up episode one. We'll see you guys on the next one.
Love.
Love.
Thank you.
Peace.
Be safe.